I think women are mad delicate. Like, you guys don't like honesty, man. The world has just become so soft that, you know, you don't like no form of honesty. Like, I'm here thinking, yeah, I know what you're going to say. I think you guys are going to try cap. But if your downstairs wasn't, you know, operating correctly, how would you want someone to tell you that? Would you want someone to tell you that?
Like, I don't expect a stranger to come and be like, sit next to me in a bus, like, dear, is that you? Like, please, mind your business. I don't know you like that. Yeah. But some people appreciate strangers telling them things, like, you've got something in your teeth, you've got something, your tag sticking out there. Mm. But I guess it depends on how private and intimate the topic is. Like, if a stranger told me my vagina stinks, first, it is kicking, because how can you smell me as a bystander on the bus? Because in the moment, I think I'd be thinking, how dare you? Like, yeah, you don't even know course, me. But in hindsight, I'm like, now I'm going home and I'm going to fix it. Do you know what I mean? Yeah. Has she not told me? Maybe no one would have told me for like another week and a half. Yeah. So I feel like you need to kind of separate from your feelings in the moment and then how actually going forward, do you know what? That was actually beneficial. As much as it killed my soul, left my body, going forward, like, it was actually the better option than not knowing.
Okay, so what if it was like, forget a boyfriend because you got a level of comfortability and vulnerability with your partner. Like, you're dating someone. Let's say you're about to smash for the first time. You could, whatever constitutes to you offering your pant for a guy for the first time, you've gone through the motion. It gets to the day, it's time, you know, gets down there. He stops. How does that play out? How should he tell you?
What's I think the what you're saying doesn't make any sense.
How do you want to be told because your pussy stinks?
No, because he just said, yeah, women are sensitive. For the first time you meet someone and they go downstairs and go, if a woman did that, you'd be offended too.
No, because...
The example you've given is stupid.
Okay,
a man would be offended in that situation.
Put the example in however you want it. What I was basically trying to establish is, I was just obviously being animated, but...
Yeah.
A guy is about to have sex. Okay, what is the polite way for guys to tell that
but
your pussy
is
not...
But what if it's a genuine reaction? You know when you smell something bad?
Let's hear this first.
Let me even answer her back. It's not rude, first and foremost. Yeah.
It is rude. So if you somebody said, did it to you...
I'm going to answer you. It's not rude. I appreciate the honesty. Somebody is a stranger, they smell it, it's none of your business. In actual fact, it's actually their business because it smells.
No, I said that's how you would feel.
No, I know, yeah. But I'm saying the reality of it is it's become their business. I can smell this. So if it's making me uncomfortable, darling, I'm going to let you know
Lucas,
it's making me uncomfortable.
You're lying. You go around to a stranger and tell her they have vagina stings.
My darling,
you can just move.
Listen.
You can just move.
Again, this is most people. I'm not most people. If me and you are about to have sex and your fanny stinks, right? I'm letting you know. Listen, it's kicking. Can you smell that? Like, what's going on? Like, and this is the thing that a lot of people do.
I don't think you would.
A lot of people talk. Then you don't know me.
The first time.
A lot of people.
I would not have sex
with
a man and his
smell
dick smells.
I will tell you. You stink.
I'm not doing that.
If you have stuff in your teeth, I'll be like, yo, go look in the mirror, science in your teeth. I will let you know. Do you know why? I hate embarrassment. I hate going somewhere, being around people, and I'm the center of attention for all the negative reasons. Like, let me know what's going on. Like, you stink? Let me know. Tomorrow I won't stink.
Lani, how would you?
You
want
don't
to be
let
told?
Me know. Then I live the rest of my life like that. That's fuckery.
I don't think I'm not that sensitive about.
How would you want to be
being
told?
Cussed, though, because
so
I've
then
been
how can you say
life.
That a guy doing this is rude?
No, it's rude.
So how would you want to be
but
told?
But I wouldn't cry over it.
So how would you want to be told? Just, what's a nice
just
way?
Just tell me.
Hey baby, smells a bit.
No. I just don't believe that women are sensitive. The scenario you gave, I feel like most people would be offended. I wouldn't be offended
if a girl told me that I didn't smell great downstairs.
I wouldn't be
offended.
I would be mortified, but I wouldn't be like he was being rude.
My soul
would leave my body.
I'd be less offended if she told me than if it ended up in a group chat and I still was left unawares.
No, of course. I wouldn't be offended, but I'm not sensitive because I have been brought up, I've been cussed all my life. Like my mum will cuss me and be like, oh, you look black and fat. Like I'm used to, like
that's
I'm
crazy.
Used to
Shout
being cussed.
Shout out to Annie though, right? Can we
no,
just
no,
get
no,
on
no,
camera?
No, but like? That's why, okay, you have to, the reason, okay, the scenario you gave was extreme, right?
Not
but
really, it happens a lot, bro. Girls
okay,
be woofing, fam.
Fair enough, but like I personally have a dark sense of humor, yeah. Me personally. Yeah. So I can, even though I look like this, I can
sex
take it.
Smell. Blood, what sex smell? Blood, like your fan.
There
like,
is a sex just, smell though.
Bruv.
There's no sex smell.
It's not. It's
it depends
disgusting.
On the sex.
Like
it depends on the sex.
You know, like it's not like a dirty scent. Oh, yeah, or yeah.
There's
nasty
sex
scent.
Smell, then
like,
there's you smell.
Everyone likes the, oh, there's this. No, how about you lot are just fucking nasty. Like something stinks in here and we need to get to the bottom of it. How about we have a conversation? You might have BV, love. Maybe you need to go see a doctor or something. Make sure your things are right. Maybe your pH is. Too many men are coming inside.
And sometimes men throw off
your
pH. There's that fact as well. Obviously, like, men can throw off a woman's pH balance, but all I'm saying is that I'm saying all this stuff, but I'm uncomfortable telling a girl that she doesn't smell good.
Yeah, I was just gonna say.
And obviously, most girls that I've dealt with in that in a sexual capacity have not been women I've been in a relationship with. It's women I've had relations with, and more time I'm discovering that on the first time I'm about to encounter them in that way. So I won't tell them, I just won't link them again. So sometimes
girls are thinking, through with it.
It depends on the kind of smell we're talking about.
If it's so, a little bit bad.
No, no, there's different levels to smelling
pumps. Yeah, if it's a little bit bad, will you...
No, but then, and this is where men are insensitive. Yeah, we're savage like that.
Because once you class it as bad, that no longer...
Okay, cool, but there's different levels of bad. It can be like, oh my God!
No.
And it can be like...
No, there's no different levels of bad.
There is.
No, I'm telling you my experience.
If it's a little bit...
I'm telling you my experience. So would you listen to it?
Yeah, okay, go on.
So my experience is this. Obviously, I saw this debate the other day that there's no such thing as an odorless vagina, but... When men them say it smells like water, it's water, it's whatever, it means that there is the minimum amount of scent that could possibly be emitted from that is different to the rest of her skin. So some girls, you smell them here, it smells the same there. It's just obviously there's more sweat or whatever. So it won't stink. You will never use a negative term.
No, vagina, she will have
her natural scent.
That's not what I'm asking you.
I'm getting there. It's a long-winded answer, love. So where she has a natural scent, you wouldn't say it smells. Some people have strong odors. Some people have their own strong odors,
but they don't stink.
But there is what people now say, oh, a fishy smell and that. Once you start getting that down there, that's gone off.
So you don't carry on with the sex?
If it is at that point where I think
it's a little bit fishy.
If it's fishy, I can't deal.
If it's a little bit fishy.
If it's a little bit fishy, there's a hint,
but you're not even entirely sure.
If there's a little hint, I might run, but I'm not going down on you. I can't go down on anything that has a scent. Like a scent beyond a scent.
We've all had smelly scents.
I can't go down on anyone who has a smell. I can do scent.
Yeah.
So what that fishy thing on any scale is a smell. I can't deal with that. And I most likely won't see you again. Because I'm just not comfortable telling her. I've only told one girl ever that her vagina didn't smell great. Actually two. And they both held it against me forever. So I'm just not comfortable telling a girl she doesn't smell great. Women don't like honesty. I've always said that women don't like honesty. They like liars. And they like the truth bent. Women can't take straight honesty.
You lot just act for the camera, man.
What do you mean?
Act
how?
For the camera,
what about men? Fake. Ask your question. What about men? Fake. Men like honesty.
No, you lot act like, yeah, I'm a big man. Yeah, you can say anything to me. You lot are crybabies too.
There's certain things that men don't want to hear, just like there's certain things women don't want to hear.
I wouldn't want to hear I have a small dick.
So my thing is, I don't feel like it's this, like, it doesn't matter where it's coming from, what the topic is, what it's about. Men will take hard, honest truth above everything, every time. We all like a certain level of tact when we're speaking about certain things. What you might need tact on is going to be something differently, completely. What I need tact on, right? But no one wants brutal honesty all the time. That's not a nice way to live. Like, no one lives like that.
But at the same time,
when we talk about friendship dynamics and dynamics between groups of women and groups of men, I do feel like there is a difference. Of course, you knew he was going to say that. Why are you even like this? Of course.
But my ex had a bigger dick than you. I'm not going to lie to you.
Wait, how do you know how big Lucas's dick is?
No, I'm saying this is a fake.
You heard it here first, guys. Nani knows how big Lucas's cock is.
Hypothetically.
Yeah, but what she can tell from your print? What she can tell from your print?
Hypothetically, if a girl said that to you, oh, my ex had a bigger dick than you, that's what you want to hear?
I'm like, why are you telling me that though?
Why are you telling me that? And this is the thing, like, you know, please.
I'm like, well, my old thing's pussy smelled nicer than yours. Where are we going now? We're not having sex. We've killed the vibe.
No, what are you talking about?
You just said something now, yeah, and I've just given you a response, and that is the response. Like, okay, your ex. Like, your ex has got a bigger dick.
Okay, and I think you're childish.
Am I not fucking?
Wait. I think you're childish.
And that's how men think. Wait. Like, okay, your ex could have the biggest dick, so I'm the one fucking you now with my small dick. Okay.
I'm not gonna lie. No, let's be real. I'm not gonna lie. If you said that, I'd probably be rattled.
No, but I don't care. Even
if that nigga's dead, I'll be rattled.
Remember, all men are different. Okay.
I'll be like, show me. I like, prove it.
Why is it okay for you to prove be rattled it. Over that, but we're sensitive because we're rattled
no,
over
no,
smell?
No one said it's not.
It's
no,
the same
sit
thing.
Sit down. Can you sit down, please?
No, I don't want to sit down because you are a hypocrite.
You know, like what I'm saying. To
how
you,
am I a hypocrite?
You're a hypocrite. Just different.
But I never said no. Lonnie, what we're saying is, listen. We're not saying men aren't sensitive to certain things. What we're saying is that, generally speaking, I feel obviously this conversation is going different angles. But what I'm saying is that
I feel like it's
harder to be honest with a woman when it comes to sensitive matters because women are more
I think it
depends on what you're talking to men about. I feel like no man wants to hear, like, you're fucking broke, you're a bum. Even if that's the fact.
She's right.
Men don't want to hear that. And I'm not talking about...
You're right.
Right, right.
But, however, if you're fucking me and I'm broke, No, I'm banging you, you dickhead, with my broke self. Clear off.
Lucas, why do you keep bringing it to people you're having sex with?
We're not. No, remember, we came from smelling pussy and all that kind of stuff. Don't make me sound like I'm.
I keep trying to move the conversation along and you bring it back. That's
because that's what it boils down to. I don't give a shit.
The conversation is progressing, so I'm saying, can we cut that out? We're not talking about that anymore.
No, I'm actually telling you, this, and this is what women do.
You are getting defensive.
No, I'm not, darling.
Yes, you are, darling.
What I'm actually saying to you is I don't give a fuck.
You do give a fuck because you're brokey. You're broken. And you have your fucking
but
feelings.
But I will still fuck you. And you will still fuck me.
When you go home, you cry because you're broke.
Why would I cry?
Because that's what you're sensitive over.
Okay, listen. That's, if we take the sex and brokey vibes out of it, let's be real, yeah? If we're talking about giving relationship advice, women are more reluctant to tell their girls the hard truth because they feel like their friend will lash out on them. And men tend to not have that. If my boy is moving mad, he's dating someone, he's loose boarding, as we call it, I'll be like, bro, I'm not sure that's the pattern you want to pattern with. Whether you're going to like what I'm saying to you or not, I'm going to tell you. And I feel way more comfortable telling you that than going to tell a girl, sis, you're getting taken for a dickhead. Yeah, because often girls will be like, I'm not even going to tell her nothing because if I tell her something, she's going to feel a way about what I'm saying. Some women are even reluctant to tell you that they think your man is attractive because, now you're...
Do you know how fucked it is, yeah? It's like how girls, when they see each other, babe, you're buff, you know, you look so good today, babe. Bro, you know your friend is the deadest thing, bro. Like, you know she's butters. Like, you just didn't need to say anything. Yeah. Oh, the dress is nice. You overly hype each other for no reason. The guys that are around you are like...
Says you, who was promoting self-love before. What can't I promote self-love in my partner's friend? She can love her butterness.
Be real with yourself.
No, but she can love her butterness and we can say, yes, sis, you look good for your butter self. I don't get it.
But you lot don't mean saying that last bit.
Okay, but hold on. Seriously, that's actually a good
point.
If we know that, if we know that someone is unattractive and we know that person knows they're unattractive and it's eating at them and it's bothering them, they're telling us, I'm going to go and get this, I'm going to go and get this done. For someone, it may be honest. Like, some people you can say, listen, you are butters, but it doesn't matter what you look like. And that's enough. But that's not going to do the trick for other people. It's really hard to love yourself when no one else is telling you there's something worth loving. Do you know what I mean?
So I hear that.
I totally get what you're saying. Like, in a perfect world, brutal honesty would work. But humans, we're social beings. Like, it doesn't work like that all the time. Sometimes that's beneficial. Other times it's destructive. You don't need to be brutally honest every single time in order for your honesty to be valuable.
And I think brutally honest too is also destructive. And I feel like the point you made is great, but I said it in a very, not as deep, not even so much jovial, but it's just not as deep. Like, girls, when they see each other, babe, you're here. Babe.
You should go. And
9 times out of 10.
Is that a bad thing, though?
I'm not saying it's a bad thing. What I'm saying is 9 times out of 10, you don't mean that. You don't feel that. It's not that. With men, we don't do that. Bro, you got a nice trim. All right, cool.
I'm trying to be like you, bro. Why are you trying to be like me? You don't know my situation.
With men, we also know that I'm trying to be like you, bro. It's cool.
Yeah, cap.
Do you know what I'm saying? We also know that it's almost like an unwritten rule amongst us. Like, okay, you're broke, so deal with your brokenness.
Do you tell your friend that their tune is dead? Because a lot of you let your friends go out, put their songs out. What about that? That's the biggest cap that you lot do.
I don't have friends that do.
And I saw on TikTok, so I know it's a lie because it went viral on TikTok. One boy was saying when he's telling his friend that his dead tune is good.
Maybe it's those boys. And this is the problem with women. You can't take the guy, for example. You can't take the boy that you see on TikTok and attribute that to the boy that you're talking to there.
It went viral.
So does that mean that he's the guy that you base this on?
No, it was relatable to a lot of people. People are laughing in the comments. It's true, man.
Something can be funny. Doesn't mean that it's relatable. It was relatable. I will do it.
It was relatable.
And this is why social media is fucked up. A lot of people...
Stop pretending that men don't lie to their friends.
That's not what we're saying here. A lot of people see things on social media. You can do things in the comment, laugh, like, all of this kind of shit. In reality, you would never do half of that shit. And that's the thing with what we're explaining now. You see your girl, you don't have to say, oh yeah, babe, you look good, you know. You know your friend don't look good. You could have just not said nothing. With men, we will tell you, yo, brother.
Yeah, pattern up.
Go change.
Do you know what? I think it depends.
Your
because
lip is dry.
I do have friends.
Yeah, man, like, bro, like,
I do have friends I can be brutally honest with. Yeah. But it's a minute amount. Most of my friends, I would have to be very delicate with the truth. There are certain friends, like, I speak to people all the time. Me and Maria, I'll say to Maria, you're not coming out with me dressed like that. Go and change. Like, you're not embarrassing me today. But that's just Maria. I can't, or my sister maybe. Majority of my friends I can't do that with. But you know what? That's fine. They need a message delivered in a certain way. I'm happy to oblige. It's actually okay. There's some days where I can probably take your brutal honesty, and there's some days, for whatever reason, I'm on the edge. I really don't need your brutal honesty. Not today, I beg, please.
Let me ask you a question, because obviously we're talking about women, and I kind of posed the question that way. So you kind of said, what about men? So do you think men are sensitive as well? And do you think like that? So tell me about that.
I feel like, don't get me wrong, I feel like men do have good banter amongst themselves, yeah? So if you're talking about that, yes. But I feel like most of the time, you lot are talking about men, like, okay, maybe men may be too tough. I'm not as sensitive about appearance and certain things.
I think we are.
Yeah, I think we are too.
However,
I think we're just not allowed to show it.
Okay, maybe you're not allowed to show it. But I just do feel like... I do. Okay, but if you compare like women and men and their appearance thing, I think women are a bit more into...
No.
Okay, maybe I'm wrong. But I've, like Azriah said, it's just different areas. Yeah. There are certain things that you guys will go home and cry over that we wouldn't care about.
I'm not going to lie to you. I'm searching within myself right now to look for something within myself that can make me feel
away.
Yeah, like, not that I don't get upset, or not that I don't feel ugly, I don't get down or all of these things, but my core is beautiful. I don't give a fuck. Like, and I feel like if you don't have that in your head frame or in your brain, you're very, very like frivolous. You can go with the wind. You can go any which
way. You have to be sure of yourself. Like,
me personally, I am a man that has full vim and confidence in who the fuck I am. Whether you like it or not, I really don't give a fuck.
In your personal life, you have your strengths and weaknesses. You've assessed yourself. What if somebody was to target something that you saw as a weakness within yourself that you were yet to improve?
They're targeting that as a
weakness. But you're telling me that if somebody highlighted a weakness of yours, that something that you were very...
I already know it's a weakness.
Hold up. So they've highlighted it and they're like kind of targeting it. You're telling me it won't affect you in any way?
Right. I didn't say I don't get upset. Of course I can get upset. Do you get what I'm saying to you? But for it to affect my core, in that moment, because you're cussing, we are cussing each other. You're saying things that are going to hurt me. You big nose prick, rare. You're cussing me. So I'm going to feel a type of way. But outside of that cussing, do I think I'm a big nose prick even though my nose is big? No, I don't give a fuck. But when we're cussing each other, the effects of what you're trying to do to each other, of course. I'm not saying that you don't feel or are sensitive to things that people are doing with intent. What I'm saying is, in life, bruv, you are what you are. Like, and if you don't accept who the fuck you are, people won't fucking make you appreciate you for who you are.
But what if who you are is Butters? You're supposed to accept that I'm Butters?
Yeah. Accepting the fact that you're Butters, my G, is where people see the beauty in you.
I've accepted that I'm not going to be six foot tall.
If you accept your flaws, it's like how people
say... So, Lani, what are you objecting to? Hold on, wait. Lani, what are you objecting to?
No.
It's like how people say manifestation and
projecting. Why do you accept that you're Butters?
There's two different types of people in the world. There's people who will convince, and I don't say this in a bad way, there's people, there's people who will take their flaws and convince themselves that their flaws are beautiful. If that's your tactic, that's fine. There's also people in this life who will take their flaws and tell themselves, you know what, this is a flaw, quote unquote, but it doesn't matter. And that's the difference. There's some people who will look in the mirror and say, do you know what, I know I don't fit this standard. I know I don't have this, which is impressive. I know I don't look like this, which people like, but I don't care because all the things that are important, I have. All the things that matter, I have. Whereas some people, and that's the difference between you get people who are like quite assured and confident regardless, and people who do struggle with their insecurity.
I think it's what you get instilled with like when you're young, you know, because I think one of the things that I got told as a kid...
But at the same time, we live in the world that doesn't believe... The world doesn't believe that as a whole.
One of the things that got instilled in me as a kid was, no matter what, your difference is what makes you unique. That uniqueness is beauty. Everybody that looks the same, to me, and this is just honest, my fundamentals. Everybody that looks the same, who wants to look the same? You like everybody else. So I grew up thinking, bruv, even if I got a big nose, like, my nose is bigger than you. That's what makes me Lucas. That's what makes me Big Nose Painting. That's why I say on Snap, Big Nose Painting. I don't give a fuck.
I've never noticed your nose is big. Do you think it's big?
I've grown up with it being...
Yeah. Bruv, my nostrils, if I flare my nostrils... You told me he was good looking. And I'm the only one who used the example to say just because your butt is...
He's mentioned his nose a lot and I didn't realise...
Again, remember you said
because I've never looked at Lucas's nose and had an opinion on his nose.
Because I mentioned it a lot, because I say... There's nothing you can say to me that can disarm me.
That'll make you feel away
like,
about
bro,
it.
Bro, it's my nose.
But listen to this, yeah. But what I've found is like, kind of where this conversation stemmed from for the viewers, obviously they won't know. Like, what we were talking about, I use the term blick prior to us filming, and I find that women, and let's go down the colorism path just a little bit, I find that like women hold on to things, certain things that they experience longer than men do, and they think it's because it affected them more, but I argue that it's because they're allowed to show that it affected them, whereas with men we just have to swallow things up and run with it. Whereas when I was young, I wanted to look like Bow Wow or Romeo, just to be that off brown, have a bit of a Marian, you know, let's have a bit wavy hair, slick hair, because I was called picky hair, pepper grain. I didn't understand all these things, and I thought, right, I want to be like the whoever's seen as the buff you. So that was hazel-eyed, light-skinned boys. So, but as black boys, we weren't, or as young men, you don't express that as much because no one takes it seriously. So I find it interesting that women kind of have this perception that men are bulletproof, and
We're actually not.
We have to deal with the same shit
too. We had to deal with the same stigmas
affect you on God affected man too.
Yeah.
But we're just not allowed.
Do you know why I feel like
even on the same level?
Do you know why I feel like this happens? Because if you look at these conversations back and forth, yeah, like we've got to this point, but it started with women are too sensitive. Yeah. Now it's women are allowed to show their emotions, men are not, and so that's where the disconnect happens. Because maybe we are too sensitive, and maybe that sensitive is heightened in comparison to how sensitive men are not allowed to be.
I made that statement at the beginning to rattle the conversation.
I don't feel like you said anything or contradicted yourself, but I feel like it's interesting because I feel like the conversation is taking a natural course. But you see it online all the time. Like, on the one hand, women are told they're too sensitive. This is why you guys struggle with your insecurities, because as boys, we cuss each other and we just got on with it. But then on the flip side, it's like, you know, but at the same time, also, we got on with it because we had to. But had we been given the opportunity to kind of say, do you know what, rah, this could have fucked me up. Yeah. If I didn't have to get on with it, this could have fucked me up. Mm. Do you know what I mean? And I feel like there's that.
But I feel like it didn't fuck us up because we had to get on with it.
No, but we don't know that. Do you know why? Okay.
I'm just saying.
Yeah, no, but because Lani, I think we was even going to have a conversation about artists dating black women, like, oh, black artists dating black women. And I think it ties into that as well, because think about it, yeah, we used to have a couple rappers, yeah, I can't be sure, so if I'm talking about you and I was wrong, forgive me, but I'm pretty sure Mo Stack, Stormzy, Crept, I think all at some point in their lyrics, Jay Huss, they've all referred to themselves as ugly. All these guys are young black guys that come from inner city, more time they probably interacted with women that look like themselves. That's where I believe they got the belief that they were ugly from. So my thing is, the way they translate it in the music might come across differently, but it's just evidence that it still affected everyone. So like, when it comes to dating lighties or whatever, the reason why people place so much value on those kind of relationships or being with people of a certain aesthetic is because it's proof that, well, I can get what the world sees as beautiful. Even if it's not me, I can secure that. So how am I what you said I was? But it comes from a lot of that, the way they perceive themselves comes from how they grew up and the people that were around them, which happened to be people who look like them.
I think that just on touching on that black men going out white women stuff, I think it's just, for me anyway, I just think it's fucked, like us even having the conversation or the debate. We're living in a country where black men are not predominantly seeing black women. The majority of them.
Well, it's debatable. Depends where you are. I hear what you're saying.
Majority of black men.
Not if you grew up in the hood, though.
Again,
it depends on your world.
You're assuming that majority of the black people that live in the hood make up the majority.
Like, no, but that's not the point.
There's people all over.
It's your world.
Hold on, let me finish.
It's your pocket.
Let me finish, please. Our black women especially get annoyed about, you know, the way that we perpetuate or the elite. Black men in the music industry, football, how they perpetuate and go after white women. And I always say, or light-skinned women, and I always say to you, what are they surrounded by? How many black women are in football? How many black women are in entertainment then? Do you get what I'm saying? A lot more now. The industry is
Do you agree that those men's pursuit of those kind of women stems from the insecurities that they had growing up? Because we're saying that men,
what they're familiar with in terms of interaction.
No, but let's focus on the. I want us to focus on the bit about the things that were said and done to us. So I want to ask you, like, do you reckon, like, man, them flipping to like, okay, I'm only doing lighties because that's buff or white skin. Do you think that's because of what they experience?
Yeah. In that, that's what every society is showing you as the standard of pengness. So even though you have been deemed as ugly, or you classify yourself as part of the ugly set or whatever, it's like, okay, well, I can still bag
what you class
as
paying. Yeah.
And it come, it can, you no, kind no, of come away from
black man. I know you want to.
So I just feel like it's obviously it makes sense, but I just feel like it's an excuse. I'm
but
sorry.
Why is it? And this is
so
the
why
thing,
is guys, our things excuses, why but your thing reasons?
Excuses, but you think
excuse
you've got,
me.
Yeah,
but
like,
okay, if we're gonna particularly talk about black people, all right? Because you want to talk about the whole country.
How dare you invalidate my experience?
The majority of black people are in the country. I think live in London, right?
Well, in the
cities. The majority of black people in England live in London.
They live in the cities. They live in certain cities.
I know that there's a huge portion of black people in Birmingham.
I never said there wasn't.
No.
They live in the cities.
I know, but what we're saying is the most amount of people concentrated in one place is in London, and there's other metropolitan cities like Birmingham, Manchester. But if you go to all those places that are not big, dominant cities.
I just don't
want to
say yes, just in case.
No, it's a fact. Most black people in this country live in one of those dominant cities, Manchester, Birmingham, London, those ones.
There's a big Asian community in Birmingham. So I feel like even though you live in a multicultural society, in your little pocket, in your little area, in your little world, in your school, in your job down the road.
Because I'm black, my pocket is little.
Your pocket is black, your pocket is Asian. So all these,
what
no.
What are you talking about?
I get what you're saying.
All these footballers that come up. No, I'm sorry. It's not difficult for them to find a black woman. All these footballers.
Let me finish the point I was making.
Lonnie, you're wrong, because you see the young guy who becomes a professional footballer is removed from his community because them clubs,
again,
they're not playing.
All them,
just because you're seeing them with their black colleagues and stuff, just because there's another player on their team of 22 that's black, they are removed.
But they grew up.
No. This is the problem. Yeah, I agree with you. So I'm not using it as an excuse. I'm just giving
what
you.
What about the ones from Africa?
I'm not using it as an excuse, but I'm giving you a reason that you might not be looking at.
I don't think it's a reason.
I'm giving you a reason you can't hear it if you don't know what the reason is. I haven't given it to you. So the reason is this, yeah? I feel like people, when you are removed from a situation, you enter a new situation, you adjust to the situation. We talked about this the other day. I can't remember. We were talking about race and stuff. So the person who's black who takes the bass out of the voice when they're surrounded by white people is the same thing as a young black man or young black woman who now enters a community where they are even more so the minority than they already are in the UK. Just being in the UK, in London, we're a minority, but we're in a bit more comfortable minority as opposed to if we were to go to, like, I don't know, Shropshire or somewhere where there's...
Well, I disagree.
My point is, when you get to Shropshire... there's far less black people, so you are singled out even more. Therefore,
there's a huge chance you come out of your comfort zone
and you adjust to those around you, and it just also reflects in your relationship.
No, I disagree.
I love
when
that.
I
you want to date a white man?
When
so
I was 16, I went to a selective school for my A levels. There was no black girls, and then I went to Leeds University, because I got really good A levels, and I left there because the reason I left is actually due to race. I just didn't feel comfortable.
Okay.
Because in my art. Basically, when we have lectures, everyone that did anything artsy, like which is like 300 to 500 people, would be in some similar lectures, and I was like one of the only black people, and I felt really uncomfortable and stuff like that. So I've been put in experiences where I've been taken out of the black, but of London.
And you left those experiences. You weren't a professional footballer.
Me personally, yes, but it doesn't.
And you took yourself away from the one that
you
were in.
No, but I was still there for like 4 years.
But you still took yourself away.
The point is, I didn't once think, I don't want my black kings, now I'm surrounded by white men.
Again, your experiences, you said 16, that's why I said I appreciate the fact you said 16.
Excuse.
London, East London, right? Woodford. Woodford isn't predominantly bare black people, it's very multicultural. But the area, you're interacting with so many different people, you rarely see actual black women. Now, it's more and more. And that's what I'm saying. In London, you have pockets of black communities. But it's surrounded by predominantly white people. This is a white country. The black men that are growing up are predominantly seeing white women. What you see in your TVs, again, the music in this country, not from our generation, now is black women in TV and all different types of shades and colours. Excellent. When we was growing up, it was all white women on TV. There was hardly any black women.
I'm not gonna lie, I grew up MTV. On MTV base. But I was
again,
watching black
everybody
women,
that's from the hood, not everybody could afford MTV and Sky. We talk like a sift. Everybody could afford these things. Facts. So when you see a guy that's really from the hood, and he's actually made it as a footballer, and he's now seen and he's around and surrounded by what they classify as the standard of beauty in his world. How do you not understand that young black boys will be attracted to them?
Just to summarize, like I started it with like a triggering question about like how would you want to be told your pussy stank sort of thing. But the point we were highlighting was like I just feel like men and women treat things we treat sensitive matters differently, and unfortunately like, it even themes into what we're talking about, like surgery and stuff. It's like the little things that we mention to each other we don't harbor onto the same way women do, and I just find it that even though we've gone down the path we're talking about relationships and footballers and stuff, what we're talking about, because like I said, off camera, this started off from using the term blick. And I just find that men were trained to take certain information, take it on the chin and move on, whereas with women, they're allowed to harbour it and manifest into something that it becomes toxic in a way, because it can change the way they perceive themselves and the way they perceive, the way they believe other people's perception of them too.
Women are sensitive and they've been allowed to be express themselves, whereas we've been so, okay, you're not allowed to really express yourself. Yeah, conditioned. I think that not being a level playing field hasn't allowed both of us to sort of like organically.
I think what we learned here today is basically just like, don't let your vagina smell. I think that's just how to avoid all the problems in the world.
I had a serious face, but I knew he was going to say some stupid shit.
That's just it. Yeah, like if you just don't smell, fam, that's the key to life, bro.